Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Python GB is here. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, I'm good, thanks, man. How are you doing?
I'm great, man. I'm really looking forward to getting my diamonds, man. Have you brought them with you?
Yeah, here they are. They've had a slight transformation, but they are definitely still diamonds.
They've turned green, man. What's going on? What's this about, Python man? I come over here, I make a wonderful garden in front of your base, and you ain't gonna pay me.
It is a wonderful garden. It is a beautiful garden. But I'm telling you, man, these are definitely diamonds. I mean, clearly. I mean, look. Hmm. They've got a nice greeny-brown shine to them.
On closer inspection, they might just be. But hey, man, I'm messing about here. I'm messing about. I came over here and did all of this without even asking you. So I'm kind of glad that you like it. It goes really well,
absolutely.
Man. All of this goes...
Yeah, man, it's a beautiful garden.
Oh, dibs! Dibs!
Red box!
I've just spotted a Hermitron. Do you know what? I've never opened one of these and got Mythic, and that's on Fallcraft as well. Common, uncommon, rare.
No Mythic.
No Mythic for me. Not today.
Well, enjoy your free glass.
Free glass, red glass, yeah. It won't be useful for long though, will it, Python?
No, it won't be useful for long because a little bit of announcement. It's not even a little announcement. It is a big, big announcement.
It's a huge announcement.
Would you like to take the lead?
I will take the lead. First of all, I'd like to say, though, that yesterday was April Fool's. You unfortunately weren't there, but some of us hermits posted an April Fool's video with the title along the lines of Season 5 of Hermitcraft, right?
Yes.
All of that was a joke. However, we timed it deliberately because Season 5, people... is going to be starting very soon. Very soon.
Oh, yeah!
Python's excited.
I'm so excited!
I think the talk of Season 5 alone got you back on here, or was it purely the Sea Town, which you've now finished? The Sea Town.
It was the Sea Town, and also getting hyped up for Season 5, man. It was a combination of the two.
Getting you in that Hermitcraft, Minecraft mood, I see.
Oh, yes!
So, the 13th of April... will be the 5th year anniversary of when Hermitcraft started. So, it kind of makes sense for that to be the day that Hermitcraft Season 5 starts, right?
5 years. That's nearly a quarter of my entire lifespan this entire community has existed. That's crazy.
It is crazy, right? Oh man, 5 years. It is really a lot. And we'll be recording a few days beforehand, so... like, the videos come out on the 13th, so you can put that in your calendar, look forward to it. Season 5 will be starting on the 13th. It means that this world is coming to an end, and I think some people have been sensing it, you know? Popped on here and finished up things. Pretty much most of the Hermits have spent their time finishing up things. I've finished up all, with exception of one of my projects I was doing on this season and this server, and then I've come over here and tried to finish up the Purple District, which is kind of what we want to do today, right?
Yeah, that's right. Get up nice looking.
Yeah, so for all of you who are going to ask, I know you're going to ask, there will be a world download of Season 4. You will be able to play in this world that we have been playing on for the last, like, what is it, a year and a month? Year and 2 months? Something like that?
Yeah, around that, yeah.
Yeah, and it's also, for both of us, it's not our last episodes. There will be more episodes. We've got a group event planned, and I'm going to be recording a group event and like a little bit of a talk/tour episode to kind of wind down the season and talk about all the unfinished projects or, well, the one unfinished project that I have. But anyway, enough about announcements and what's going on. We got this big ugly area right here, Python. There's yellow, there's like grey and white clay, and it's not very good, is it?
Nah, it's not. So, yeah, I'm thinking let's start off by replacing all of this with grass.
All of it, just grass. You want to tear out this and only put grass down, or we were brainstorming a little bit, weren't we? You mentioned brown concrete as a possible block.
Yes, in terms of pathways, yeah. It'd be quite nice to chuck that down.
Okay, well, Cleo needs a path, so in terms, like, all the paths are kind of done, except Cleo, the front of her base, just sort of, the path comes here and then it ends here. Also, there's a pool of blood on the ground.
Oh, lovely.
So we could like steer that around. I was thinking we could steer it around into here. So maybe we'll try and mix in some brown concrete. brown concrete powder as a bit of a path block. But yeah, all of this white clay is going to go, all of this grey stuff, we're going to throw down the grass. So basically, this area is going to end up looking like this stuff over here, you reckon? Is this what we're going for?
Yeah.
So we'll throw down a few kind of design stubs and things like that in there as well.
Yeah, love the little shrubs.
All right, it sounds good. I guess we'll do a little bit of digging, prepare this area, do some resource gathering, you know, get everything in order.
Yeah, I'm going to go and get on with this pathway. I'll get some resources for it.
Python, I got this disgusting, horrible poop that you ordered. Ugh.
Oh, thank you so much.
Smells so bad. Why do you want this?
I don't know. What did you have to eat last night? Blimey.
I've been eating Brussels sprouts again. Please forgive me.
Oh, good lord.
So, dude, in my ender chest, I have a load of really organized chests for like building and doing projects. And here's three of them that I think are going to interest you. But you're crafting.
I've just discovered something.
What's that?
Red sand. I'm using red sand. It won't come up with a recipe.
Oh, really? Oh, I can't see what you're doing, unfortunately. Well, I might have sand somewhere in my organized chests. It might be in this box. Yes, there's some sand for you. Not a lot, but it will do for now, right?
Yes.
So if you want to take something from these chests, the rule is that you always leave one item behind. So in here, we've got our grass, we've got ferns, we've got things that we can decorate the area with. We've got leaves as well. We've got loads of different types. Oh, I do have it. I do have it, Python. Look. Look at this. Oh, we're going to use some brown...
Ooh.
I know, right? Hang on, I want a stack of that. Oh, I didn't get any. Oh, thank you.
All
that time
now.
We spent looking for different ingredients and stuff. So over here, we've got like a natural patch of hardened clay. This is some original hardened clay, okay? It's been here since day one. And we think for this area, perhaps, this sort of space... I'm going to walk across like a little bit of a boundary line, let's say. Down in this area... All this space here, we fill it up with hardened clay. We throw in some of these as well. Any other things you reckon could fit into here?
Coarse dirt, perhaps? What do you think?
Yeah, coarse dirt, absolutely. I've got some of that in my chest. I've also got podzol. Are you a fan of podzol?
I love podzol. I love the texture of that.
I'm glad you do. I was about to say I'm not so keen myself. I feel like it looks a little bit... I don't know, it doesn't blend very well. Maybe not with this. Let's have a look. So, a little bit of podzol here and there, what do you think? I'll place one down over here for you to have a look at.
It's quite a substantial change in texture, isn't it? Like, it's quite rough compared to the clay.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. It doesn't quite transition so well. So, anyway, I'll leave it as your call if we keep it or not. But let's do this little area then. Let's fill it all in with clay and make it look kind of, I don't know, dry? I think dry would be the word here.
Yeah, I like that. Awesome. So, Azuma, there's a new snapshot out, 17W13. What do you think of it, man?
I like it a lot, man. Some amazing features in this new snapshot, wouldn't you say?
Oh, yeah. You gotta love the new parrots, huh?
Yeah, I like the parrots. I like them a lot. You were just saying to me, though, a moment ago, like, what are their use? What are they used for? Why are they in the game?
Well, one of the things I was thinking of is maybe detecting dungeons or detecting like hostile mobs around you, like especially in the case of creepers. You know, you can't really hear them coming, can you?
That's a good point. But with a creeper, does it imitate its hissing sound or does it just go silent? Because the creeper's silent until it hisses. I really want to know that.
I've noticed it makes a hissing sound.
Oh, does it? Oh, that is really clever then. Yeah, they're very cool. I like it. Every time something gets added in this game, someone complains, someone moans, someone praises. Like, you just get the whole range of reactions from people, right?
Yeah, like, one of the things I've noticed is people, the recipe book system, like, oh, it's made things too easy now. Like, I've been playing this game for over 6 years, and I still don't know most of the crafting recipes, so... The fact that I could just go ahead and not even look at the wiki anymore.
I'm going to say, I think I know all of them. Like, there might be one or two that I sort of struggle with. Like, I know what they're made out of, but maybe I can't remember which way around. But I'm pretty sure I know all of them myself. I really want to find out now. I want to, like, do a crafting challenge, do you know what I mean? But
yeah.
Do you remember when they added beds to the game?
Oh yes, the ability to sleep.
We're filling this all in with grass now. there were people that complained that it would be too easy to skip the night, right? And that you should, you know, hunker down in a hole and wait for the night to pass.
Oh, I remember
right?
those
like people, days. People always complain. And I think you just got to play it and give it a chance. And I think the parrots are great. I personally think the best thing about the parrots is it's another little mob that's unique to a place that isn't a game changer in a big way. It just adds something that might be useful. But it fleshes the game out. It brings it more to life, you know? I think every biome could do with its own little mob, insect, animal, whatever, you know? Just to make the world feel more lived in.
Yeah, you've only got to think about what has been introduced recently. Like, for snow biomes, there's polar bears now. You got things in the desert biomes, husks.
That's a really good point. That kind of stuff. And I hope they continue to do that. Keep giving biomes different mobs and stuff, you know?
Yeah, more wildlife is always appreciated, in my opinion.
Bye for my man. Oh, thank you very much. How kind are you? I need that.
Hey, you're very welcome.
So we've got this little patch over here looking good. We've thrown down the trapdoors and glowstone, so it's all lit up. And now we're going to do this grassy area. So I'm guessing we're just going to throw down lots of grass, bone meal, ferns, little bits of, what do they call it, the path block? Little bit of this, little bit of that.
Yeah.
You know
and
what
then
I'm saying?
We could maybe mix in some of the burnt concrete powder next to it as well.
Yeah, give that a go for sure.
Accent it a little bit.
Throw that in there. One thing I noticed was this now looks a little bit bare over here, and I reckon what we can do is fill up the bottom with oak so it matches. That looks pretty cool. And then just throw in some trapdoors. That's a nice little bit of detail right there. That was your idea.
Yeah,
well,
that's really
it?
Nice.
But you said, you said to put fences in there, right?
Yeah, originally the plan was fences.
Fences
this looks
look
really,
good
really
too.
Good.
Well, maybe over here we'll build it up with some fences as well. Do you have any to hand?
I do not, though.
You could chuck a couple on top of those bits, and over here as well. Just do it a little different there.
You think wood fences? Oh, sorry, not wood fences, they're all wood. Oak fences!
yeah, go for it, whatever you think fits. And there is also cobblestone walls as well. Do you know what? It looks weird because it doesn't connect.
Yeah, I was just thinking that.
I'll take no, wait. Like oh, that. Okay. Oh, never mind then. We'll just go for the trapdoors. Alrighty, Python. It's looking kind of weird. Oh, by the way, this path is beautiful. It looks so good. You were just praising the brown concrete block. I got to agree with you. I think it's probably one of the nicest blocks we've had in a while. Dude.
Yeah, it goes with so many things.
It does look so good. So we decided to throw in an extra path here, which, as you pointed out, it kind of makes the pond a lot more relevant because the path goes around it and then it comes up here. But now our big open grassy area is left ready to be purdified. Let's purdified?
Purdified.
Is that the right word? Make it purdy.
Pretty sure it isn't, but we'll make it.
I think purdify is the one. Yeah, we'll use it anyway. So feel free to grab some of the stuff out of here. We got our grass, shrubberies. We need some bone meal. I do have a bone meal chest. I'll bring that out so we can bone meal up the place. And then, what else we got? Yeah, leaves. I'm going to chuck down some oak and some spruce leaves in here as well. And now we're just going to go ham and make this area look pretty, right?
Yeah! Make it pretty where the grass is green and the...
The girls are pretty.
Yeah. I don't know. All right. Yeah, man. I think this is going to look really, really nice once it's done. Like, it's been a long time coming, like, trying to get this place done.
Oh, yeah. It's needed it for a while. That's for sure.
Yeah. There we go. Just the simplest of things. Adding in some logs and leaves makes anything look better.
You found a friend, Python.
Yeah. He's already got a name as well. Don't even have to name him.
He's Chuck. I wonder who named him. I like it.
It's awesome.
Dude, do you know what else I like? This area right here, man.
Yeah, it's looking nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it's so simple. That came together really quick. Just, I think just the thick grass is all that it needed, you know. The occasional long grass as well. Some bits where it opens up, you put your ferns down the side of the path, and the spruce and the... No, actually, it's dark oak, isn't it? Dark oak and spruce looks really good there.
Yeah, and then you've got these little leaf mounds all over the place. I kind of like that. I was thinking in terms of the mounds, maybe we could do something similar with this clay area, like put some little mounds of clay just randomly in, just to give it a bit more height.
What would be on them? Like, that's I tried to
I don't know.
do. I literally tried to do this the other day. In fact, do you want to go and see it? Because I tried to do this. I tried to create a sort of brownie area with some height to it, and it didn't quite work out. Can you
Okay.
take off from the ground?
Yes.
He's got skills, peeps. He's got skills. Hang on.
Oh,
I've got skills.
there you
Amazing.
go.
Okay.
All about that
Head over to the Hungry Hungry Hermits. While I'm here, I'm gonna fly over the sea town. Mate, it's looking gorgeous. Oh, and I've hit a wall.
timing. Yeah. Yeah, I gotta thank World's Knight for helping me, keep my butt back into gear with this thing.
It's cool, man. I love that you kept the Loch Ness as well.
Oh,
She's
false.
got a
Oh, I
name,
love that
right?
thing.
Isn't it Nessie or something?
Nessie,
That's
yeah,
what I've heard other
that'll be
people
the
call
one.
her. So,
Right, Hungry Hungry Hermits. Aha!
yeah, you can see me on the ground, right? So over here, I tried to do the same sort of brown patch. I threw in some spruce leaves for height. Maybe that's what we could have put down there. And then here's where I made it a little bit taller with like spruce slabs. It just, I don't know, it's kind of like almost there. It feels like it needs a few more blocks available on the palette, to make it work.
Yeah, I think we can make it work though for sure.
All right, we'll give it a try. And while we're in the area, let's fly over to the White District. That
Oh.
was amazing. That was amazing! Oh my goodness me. Oh, I don't have a chest or the means to make a chest. Hang on, there might be something around it. Dude, that looks so cool. You just whizzed past me and then it was like splat. Oh. Are you gonna be okay to get back over here?
Yeah, I'm just going through the Log Mason's castle, so we good.
Okay. Oh, luckily I've got my wood over here. Right, excellent. I can make a chest and put your items in it.
Oh, I didn't even mean to do that.
It happens. Don't worry about it.
Oh, that's funny. That is funny. I like that.
All right, you got all your items?
Yep, all looking good.
Okay. This time, let's not kill ourselves when we fly. You were just telling me, though, you sort of skimmed across the ground, which took away 5 hearts. Then you hit the wall. So it was a bit of like a double bug or a bit of bad luck by the sounds of it.
Yeah.
So, dude, the White District has sort of been finished as well. I mean, all the buildings have
Yeah.
been sort of finished for a long time. In fact, there's a little bit here that's a bit rough, but yeah,
Yeah, the gas
Wells
station.
finally finished off the portal here, and he took inspiration from what I did and built a really cool looking kind of like lump that comes out of the ground, a little rocky lump. I love the way, though,
Yeah.
most of the obsidian is hidden here. It's just
Yeah, it
like
really gives it a nice effect.
I need to do that with my portals more, man. Whenever I build portals in this game, you can always see the obsidian, and I like the way he's put the slabs there. It just hides so much
Yeah.
more of it.
Yeah, it's really, really nice. Just a little stone mound. It's a really simple concept, but it works really well.
It does. It looks so cool. And man, like Hermitcraft is really like wrapping up well here. What do you think of this little walkway between the two areas? I kind of like this bit here, just the way it is. Maybe
Yeah, maybe it
this
could do
white
with a little
stuff
bit
is
of
ugly.
defining. Yeah.
But I think all of this can just be kept as is. We've just got a tiny little bit of work to do over here, and we can say that the purple district is done, you know?
Yeah, pretty much.
All right, is that good?
Hey, I'm thinking this is looking quite nice. Just it's not like a great deal of height, and that's what I like about it, it's quite subtle.
Yeah, it's different. I do, again, I'm going to say what I said a moment ago. I feel like the textures, though, like, oh, we just need a few more textures in this game. I feel like they need to hire someone who can look at all the colors in the game and go, oh, you're missing these colors a fair bit. You could do some more, I don't know, reds or purples. Probably not the right colors. There's probably plenty of those. But then also
Yeah.
to go, like, what about natural textures? How many natural textures do you have? How many, like, I don't know, futuristic, like put them into categories and give people more blocks that work with other blocks, fill in the gaps. That's the way I wish they'd look at it, because this game could always do with more blocks, right? And
Yeah, that's why I love 1.12. There's so many new
yeah,
blocks.
I feel like they're putting in the right stuff. Of course, by the way, we're not on the latest snapshot yet on the server. It's been really buggy, so we decided not to update it. And we're probably not going to do that for the rest of this season because it doesn't really make sense. Like there's no real reason to play that until Season 5 starts, in my mind. Plus, it's going to be kind of buggy as well, right? So Season 4 will probably just stay on the first snapshot of this one. But yeah, Python, we've done a terrific job here. We have wrapped up Purple District. It's looking great. Everything's kind of come together here for the end of the season. And is there anything you want to add? Anything you want to say?
No, not really. I think this. I think it's been a long time coming getting this Purple District done. Like, I feel like we've been sort of hanging behind the Blue District in terms of progress, but I think that's because we've got less residents here.
Exactly. Yeah, we've always had less residents. We've all been lagging behind a bit. I just spotted something that definitely needs a tweak. I'm going to grab some clay here. Just over here, you'll see it. this bit looks a little bit nasty. I think what we'll do here is fill this in.
Yeah.
And then, are you ready, Python? It's the last block of the Purple District. I'll let you place it.
Oh, you're giving me this responsibility? Wow, okay.
Oh
wow.
You threw the block.
I meant to chuck you one,
jeez.
So I have one left.
Oh.
And here we go. In three,
drum
two,
roll,
one,
please.
Boom.
Bam, you did it. Nice one.
Oh,
it's a project well done, man.
Yeah, man, this has been good.
It has been great. So I guess that kind of concludes this episode. I've had a great time recording you today, Python peeps. Be sure to check out Python. He's going to be here playing on Season 5, of course, as well with us. You're looking forward to it,
yes.
Man. You got plans, haven't you? I got plans for Season 5.
Big plans.
And it's not the last episode of the season. But anyway, if you've enjoyed it, leave a like on the video. As always, thanks for your support. And I'll see you in the next one. Ciao for now. Bye-bye.
See you later.